Like all musical styles, punk rock has its history and its traditions, and inevitably the torch is passed as artists emerge. For a new generation, punk veteran Kathleen Hanna, who co-founded the band Bikini Kill, continues to be an inspiration, especially for young women moving into this male-dominated genre. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker has the story.
As part of their Teen-tastic Tuesdays program last May, the Los Angeles Public Library hosted a young band called the Linda Lindas.
A little while before we went into lockdown, a boy in my class came up to me and said that his dad told him to stay away from Chinese people.
So this is about him and all the other racist, sexist boys in this world.
Rather unexpectedly, this performance was about to go viral. The clip of their song, Racist, Sexist Boy, was viewed millions of times online and landed the young band on late-night television.
The Linda Lindas!
For those invested in punk rock, the Linda Lindas' brief bombardment of social media feeds provided proof positive that the future was in good hands. But there was something else. The t-shirts, a not-so-subtle nod to one of punk's most seminal bands, Bikini Kill, and its singer, Kathleen Hanna. In the early 1990s, Bikini Kill, led by Kathleen Hanna, was arguably one of the most influential groups in music, an integral part of the do-it-yourself art, music, and political movement called Riot Girl, which gained prominence as alternative music came to dominate the airwaves and pop culture. The Riot Girl scene, however, existed in small clubs and college campuses, well outside of the commercial mainstream.
We booked our own tours. We had no management. We did everything ourselves, including like fixing the van most of the time. Any woman or girl at our show, I would get their address. I would write them a postcard. I'd say, here, we're going to be here, you know, this day. Put a heart or a star on your hand. If you see another girl with that, you'll know she's interested in feminism, and you guys could start a conversation. And it started working.
Taking a hammer to the male-dominated underground music world, Hanna became a punk rock feminist icon and a target as Bikini Kill's prominence grew.
If you're challenging the status quo, a bunch of jerks are going to come out of like the woodwork like termites and try and attack you. Some big magazine would write something about how we were just a bunch of sexual abuse survivors who hated men, and we were ruining the punk scene, and our shows weren't really musical, they were speak outs. I mean, I could tell you a million stories, but to have to endure that and then go on stage and be like, hey!
All girls to the front. I'm not kidding.
If I got into this to be liked, this is like the wrong business to get into. Like, we've all got to end oppression against all people. It's not about being a white woman who climbs the corporate ladder or who makes it onto a major label, or I get to play a big festival and everything's solved. It's about everyone coming together. And feminism to me really is that.
In the late 90s, Bikini Kill slowed down and Hanna would release a solo record and also formed a trio called the Tigre. Now a seasoned music veteran, she had made her mark. Bikini Kill's advocacy of what has been called girl power had become an integral part of culture. And their song Rebel Girl, an unofficial anthem, appearing in movies, television, and even Miley Cyrus's 2021 Super Bowl performance.
The weirder part of the way that things I've been involved with have seeped into popular culture is walking into Target and seeing a girl power shirt. And all the crap that we went through, you know, back in the day, it makes it worth it.
But culture is not a static affair, and recent years have not been quiet. Bikini Kill decided to reunite shortly after the 2016 election because, Hanna says, she still felt the same way she did in the 90s.
I feel the same exact amount of anger. I mean, it's not like sexism stopped existing. You know, we were checking out different booking agents that we wanted to work with, and one of them, a male, was like, well, you better strike while the iron's hot, you know, with this like Kavanaugh stuff, and you know, and I was like, don't worry, I think sexism's still gonna exist, like in next year. I don't think we need to really rush this. It's been around for a long time.
Do you find yourself checking what you say because of what we now call call out or cancel culture?
I've always been put in a position where if I say something in a sort of weird way, or I have an off interview or something like that, or even if I have a great interview, someone's going to take issue with it. And I don't care. I mean, I can't live my life that way.
Hey there.
While the pandemic postponed Bikini Kill's 2020 tour until the spring of 22, Hanna has been busy, spending her time working on her organization, Tees for Togo.
What is Tees for Togo?
Founded in 2018 and working in collaboration with an organization called the Peace Sisters, Tees for Togo sells designer t-shirts for $40 a piece, each helping to pay for a girl to go to school in Togo, West Africa for 1 year. Turns out the t-shirts worn by the Linda Lindas in their viral video clip weren't just band shirts, but Tees for Togo shirts.
Just to show how amazing the internet is, these shirts, the Linda Lindas like bought on their own, wore them in the video, and then I sold like $13,000 worth of shirts the next day.
Hanna says this year, Tees for Togo has donated over $40,000 to the Peace Sisters, helping to triple the number of girls the organization is sending to school since its founding.
When you think of a band like the Linda Lindas, against your experience, what advice would you give to a young band as young people that have something to say and want to say something in a cynical world?
I always think of it like this. A kid throws spitballs at you in your class and you think, oh, this kid is hating on me or whatever, but that kid just wants to get your attention. And it's the same way if you're somebody who speaks out in the public eye. There's going to be people who want to have some kind of relationship to you. And if they can't have a positive relationship with you, they will have a negative relationship with you. And I would tell them that the spitballs mean people are paying attention and that all of the negative stuff means it's working. And if you're not getting those negative comments, like, are you really a punk?